Oh, me hearties, a very good evening to you. It's just me, Scotty McClue, one-stop broadcaster, first lord of the internet, and I thought I'd just pop up random and say a big hi to every single one of you. Friday night, of course, nothing gets past me, and that's as good a time as any, just to pop up random and say hi to every single one of you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're live, of course, on the one-stop platform. We're on Facebook Live just for you. Haven't been up for some time, so good to have you all with us. And a very, very warm welcome, Dinky Doo. It's just me, Scotty McClue. I hope you're coping all right. Friday night, as I say, nothing gets past me, and it's good to be back with you. And Dinky Doo, if you want to pop me a wee message, of course, I can read it out. We're normally on the YouTube channel at this time of night, but we'll pop up and say, hi, there's Alan McGee. Hello, Alan. Dinky Doo from me, Scotty McClue. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Lovely to have you with us. It's some time since we're all together, I have to say. And with all this lockdown stuff, oh my goodness me. So there we are. But, you know, I just thought there's nothing much on the telly, there's nothing much on the radio, so I'll pop up and say hi to the nation and share the good news with them. We've got lots and lots of good news to share with you now. Graham Loud and Scotty Wayne gracing the airwaves again. Very soon, Graham, about 3 or 4 weeks. Hi from Gordon and wee Oliver. Hello, Gordon Robertson. Lovely to have you with us. And Dinky Doo. Excellent. Steve Burrows there. Dinky Doo, Steve, Gordon Roddick, the wonderful Gordon Roddick. Good evening, Scotty. Good evening, Gordon. Great chat. Lovely to have everybody with us. Let me run back a little bit because I missed some of the chat at the beginning. There we are. And there's Gordon. Good evening, Scotty. Alan McGee, as we say. Graham Loudon. Dinky Doo. Ian Roach is watching. Welcome, Ian. Neil Mills, welcome. Wonderful. Some big names here. Steve Burrows. Fantastic stuff. Can you say hello to my daughter, Joanna? She's sitting next to me. Alan, of course I am. Joanna Hire and Dinky Doo from Scotty McClue. Just for you on a Friday night. What about that, Joanna? There you are. I'll tell you, Dinky Doo. Wonderful stuff. Good evening. Hope you're well. McClure, Dinky Doo, can we get Ocean Radio? Is it on Dad Neil Mills? You'll get it on your app. You'll get it online. You'll get it on FM across Europe. This is huge. I've been involved in some pretty big projects in my time. But my time is just about starting. So there we go. This is huge. It's wonderful stuff. We'll tell you all about it as time goes on. Hope you're well. David Turner, Dinky Doo, Stuart Murray, lovely to have you with us. Gordon, we're starting on Ocean. We think early March, maybe as early as the 1st, but we'll see what happens. It's all being held up, of course, by the situation. But don't you worry about that. Now, I'm just going to do a tiny bit of sharing, guys, just to let everybody know. We'll not be up forever and a day, but I thought what I'd do is just pop up, see you all, and we'll do a bit of sharing here. If you can all share as well, that would be tremendous. I'm getting covered in messages here. There we are, fantastic. Right, so if you can like and share, I know it's all a bit dull, all this liking and sharing, but if you can do that, that would be fantastic. I thank you. Wonderful stuff. So there we are. So a wee like there, and then a wee share, just to let everybody know that we're live. I'll share it to the news feed, so you should get that. That's going out just now. McGinty McGinnis, Dinky Doo, loving the beard, Dinky Doo. Oh, thanks, Neil. There we are. We lockdown growth for everybody. Dinky Doo on the card with Leo tonight. How's life? Darren Dinky Doo, life is good. I started telling Ted to tell Ted. Oh, do tell Ted to tell Ted. Very important. Now, who am I sharing this with? Wait till I see what's going on. Oh, yes. We'll just put live now. Let everybody know what's going on, and then we can get on with it live now. There we go, and post that. Wonderful, because if people don't know you're on, they're not going to join you. Love that. William Russell, Dinky Doo, Peter Connolly. Welcome, 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 Scotty McClue, just popping up to say dinky-doo to every single one of you, and to let you know we're going back on the radio, back on the wireless with the phones. Oh, Peter Curley, nice to see you again as well. Fantastic. So just a quick copy of that. There we are. I'm just going to copy that, and then I can pop it in the post as I share it, you see. Oh, nothing goes past me, you know. I'm not just an athlete. Wonderful stuff, and we'll copy that and just send around to you a copy over. Wonderful stuff, and share to the group. So we'll let the Scotty McClue group know as well that we're live. Hey, Scotty, when are you on the radio next? Oh, Tony, I think it could be 3-4 weeks, that sort of thing. Can you remember the day of your podcast was paused? Who paused that? So there you are. Sorry, Alan McGee, what were you saying there? Can we remember the date of the first show, 10 p.m. to 1 a.m.? Yes, 12th of December, 1994. So what is that? That's 26 years just past. Amazing, absolutely amazing. Especially when everybody said, oh, that one will last. If it lasts the week, the way he goes on. Here we are, almost going into our 30th year, 29th year later. 26 years from Scott FM. Good evening, Scott. Hope you're well. Stephen Menzies, I hope you're well. You're doing wonderful work, my boy. Out there in all weathers and the countryside, looking after the railways. Keeping everything going. Good for you, Stephen. What a great man. It's wonderful. But I have to say, when you're doing something like that, Stephen, you get used to it, don't you? You become a man's man, as they say. You become very rugged and very sensible, as well as having a great sense of humour. Best years were in Scotland FM. Alan McGee, yes, but also, you see, Sheffield was tremendous. It was absolutely brilliant. Manchester was tremendous. Yorkshire, Lancashire, the North West, the North East, Newcastle, all these things. So it's very debatable which was the best year. Scott FM was just outstanding. That was Scotland's finest radio hour, without a doubt. And that covers all stations. Nothing has ever actually beaten that, I would say. I'll be absolutely honest with you. So there we are. I'm just looking for the Scotty McClue fan group to share this with. Yes, there it goes. Wonderful. Just to let them all know that we're live. Live now. You can't even do it. That's us. There we go. That's the group knows about it now. Scott FM. But Scott FM was, without a shadow of doubt, Scotland's finest radio hour. You're quite right, Alan. Definitely that. Back in the radio again, Scotty. I'll call you. I used to love your radio station, says McGinty McGinnis. Fantastic. Back on the radio again. The last time we spoke was Scott FM. I'll compose a wee poem in celebration. Well, I think this will be big. I met him once upon a time ago. To be honest, I was surprised he was still alive then. He wasn't the finest looking specimen in the laboratory. Who's that, Christabel? Oh, right, you're asking about Wee Fat Bob. I don't know about Wee Fat Bob. I haven't seen him for years, Christy. So there we go. So I don't know what went on there. Absolutely. But anyway, McClue's about. Kareem Zachariah has come and joined us. Dinky-doo, Kareem. I hope you're well coping with the lockdown. Oh, it's a tough gig, the lockdown. But good news, everybody. Scotty McClue's going to be back on the phone soon. Hiya, Scotty. How's you? Very good, Kareem. Better for seeing you with us. I thought we'd just do a wee pop-up or live on Facebook, because it's a wee while since we've done it, and see that everybody is well and in Dutch. Now, I'm just going to do some more sharing, guys, because if I don't do that, then you'll all go daft. You go, oh, you might have let us know, Scotty. I'd have watched that. Oh, what are you like? What are you all like? Or as some people say in Scotland, what are yous like? But listen, can I just explain to you that the plural of you is you, not yous? Aha. Now what a job I've got. That and journalist ramping everything up Forget that. Increasing is the what? My family's watching Dinky Doo. Lovely to have you with us. A top man. How marvellous is that? I've been argy-bargy with the lot of you recently about all sorts of things. Can you play a wee song, says McGinty? I think I probably can, McGinty. I'm going to play you a wee song just in a minute. We're back on the 22nd of the month. It's a bit scary. Well, that's good, Corinne. So the school's going back on the 22nd. Pro Tem, we know that, Pro Tem. Keeping busy with radio stuff early Saturday mornings. Thank you for inspiring me in radio. No, Tony, you press on. You are your own inspiration. You know, McClure, I don't know everybody says to McClure, you inspired me into radio, but you inspire yourself into it. It's wonderful. It was a long day, very interesting, jacking up a train out in the wilds, but we got a trains moving with the help of great colleagues. And Stephen, I don't know where you're working, nor is it anybody's business, but did you see the state of the Highlands, the road to Ullapool? Oh, do you remember when we were always on the weather report, the Cockbridge to Tomintoul Road is closed? Somebody said it'd be better news if they came on once and said the Cockbridge to Tomintoul Road is open. And I've actually taken the Cockbridge to Tomintoul Road. It's an amazing road. I think that would be the one I went up through Cooper Angus and kept going north to Braemar. Would that be right? Have I got that right? The pop-ups in the first lockdown probably saved a lot of people. Sanity Scotty, they certainly saved mine. Ah, Peter Connolly, but the sense that you talked on these pop-ups, absolutely incredible. They were great. Scotty, is there a start date yet for you? Yes, Karim, I think it's early March. Could be as soon as the 1st of March. And that's us back on the wireless big style. Right, I'm going to share this to our page, and then I'll get all of you in a minute. Share to a page, sharing to the Scotty McClure page. Have I done that? Did I just do that? Oh, I'll do it again. Nobody will mind a couple of shares. You know, can't you mind what I've shared to there? I'll share to another page. So what I'm doing is I'm just letting everybody know that we're live, the World's Top Talk Show, and I'd be hoping to see some of you on the YouTube channel, Scotty McClure's YouTube channel. Look that up. Wonderful. Colin Brown's watching Dinky Doo. Lovely to have you with us. How amazing is that? Keeping busy, so there we are. Good for you, Tony. That's what it's all about. Yes, Karim, it's going to be an anxious time for all of you guys, but you'll do it. My good colleague Alex is out with a big plough skipping the Perth to Inverness line open. Stephen Menzies. Listen, tell me this, Stephen. Do we have snow ploughs on the trains? You know, in America, they've got these and they go, and then they can belt it along with the snow plough. The only thing is, I would imagine they're blowing the whistle, because it looks if anything got on the road, they'd get covered in snow. If they survived it, you know, because it's just the way these things channel it. So I just wondered, do we have any snow ploughs? I've been losing the weight. It's amazing how making small changes can make a difference. Oh, absolutely, Tony. You're talking to an expert on weight here, I can tell you. Brian Hall, Dinky Doo. My goodness, that's just around the corner. What group of people is the station for EG All UK, etc.? So there we are. So fantastic. Yes, Karim, the radio station will be... what we'll be doing, we'll be going out across a good whack of Europe, going out across Spain, but you'll get us also on the apps, you'll get it online, etc. Fantastic. Ocean Radio, absolutely tremendous stuff, so there you go. So it'll be everything, but very much a European station, and based in Tenerife in the Canary Islands, all that sort of stuff. Any hints about what you were talking about, your new radio show? Well, I'm not going to tell you right now, Graham Loudon, but we'll be certainly giving it big licks with the chat, I can tell you, and the phones, you see. See, it's also, I mean, my hands have been a bit tied when you don't get the phones. And if I go on a smaller radio station, the phones trip out all the time because everybody tries to get through. And the smaller stations aren't geared for that level of phone calls. So as far as I understand, everything's all geared up technically and we'll get the phones through. So there were, in fact, somebody even said it was a free phone. So you lot will be in clover. I can tell you. Right, I'm just going to do some more sharing. Share to another page. Then we'll share to all the groups. Let everybody know what's what. Global radio and television presenter. We'll share with that lot. There we are. And remember to get onto the Scotty McClue big Facebook page. It might not be the one you're watching right now. So look out for that. So yes, lots of hints there. Ocean Radio. That's going to be the big thing. Because of course, UK radio is very dull these days, I find. Yes, we use miniature ploughs and locomotives, up to 12 inches. But we have huge big ploughs, one front, two locals, and plough in the rear that can be set to plough left or right. I would imagine you'll it's a very, very responsible job because you think, watch, there's some stuff we're passing. Next, we're going through a station, there's people stand, don't plough that. Scotty, your new callers will be interesting, a real diverse group, but us Scots will still try to get through. I think you should, Kareem. I'll be hoping you maybe manage to get on first, like you used to do on the old Nation Radio when we were on that. That was fantastic. That was local radio. Of course, this is a different ballgame. This is massive. So there we are. Susan Shaw, hi Scotty, how are you? Hello, Susan. Dinky-doo, lovely to have you with us. We're just having a quick random pop-up, Susan, just to say hi to everybody and to let them know that we're back on the wireless very soon with the full phones. So that should be rather good. So welcome, welcome, welcome. Lovely to have you with us. And what else? What else am I sharing here? Oh, yes, still sharing on the pages. There's a scotty-mcclue.com, a page called after the website. So you can get yourselves on there as well, guys. That would be fabulous. The website's at over 10 million visitors. Now, I know that's been over a wee while, but it's still quite outstanding. So we're very well, Susan. Thank you for asking. We're excited about the new show, of course. Keith Wallerspoon's watching. Hi, Keith. Lovely to have you with us. And Dinky Do, I say. That's, you're so kind, guys. That's 41 comments already. And we've just started. But I'll not keep you on it because you'll have things you want to watch, people you want to talk to, you want to make phone calls, all that stuff. And I'm very excited that we're getting sorted out here. I'll share the story as well, just to let them know that we're live, guys. I think that's fair. There's Kevin Stewart saying hello. Hello, Kevin. Lovely to have you with us. And Dinky Doo from Scotty McClue. So there we are. It can't be easy setting up a new radio station. How does Mac Radio sound? Well, it's not easy setting up a new radio station. I'm very fortunate. I've been credited with setting up two and saving two. So there we are. Lynn Dunsmore's watching. Thank you, dude. Lynn, I want to hear more about the snowplow there, guys. Yes, you're right. We stop short of stations and adjust the plows. I saw everybody doesn't get a good whiff of the snow because these big ones going across Canada and America, they were really chumming it up, you know. I mean, huge stuff. And I thought, you don't want to be anywhere near to one of those going by at speed. And they were really clearing the line. But, as I say, there was lots of hooting and tooting going on. The big steam ones as well. Oh, that's some... Oh, pardon me. Dinky-doo, long time no hear. Absolutely, Kevin. Yes, I haven't been up on Facebook, but we've done a lot of work on YouTube and on TikTok at Scotty McClue, if you're into that. But do subscribe to the YouTube channel. Can I get a Scotty badge? They look great. These are great. I don't have many left, I don't think. I've got an emergency one for if there was an emergency. And we forgot, and I keep one at the back, you see, just to let everybody know that that's there. Dinky-doo from Scotty McClue. Fantastic. There we go. But obviously, with a facade like mine, You're better on the radio, that's the one. Hello, hello, hello. Diane Marchand. Hello, Scotty. Hello, Diane Marchand. Sir Bon. Scotty Badge, we love that. Kevin's laughing his head off here. This is fantastic. How's Clyde tonight? Susan Shaw, Clyde is the most incredible little creature. I mean, the tail's going. He's well over 100 now. He's entered his 15th year. You know, and this little garter thing for the back leg, he goes, get that on. I am going out for a walk. And he took me the whole circuit last week. There was nothing I could do about it. He goes, not going back anywhere. So come on, we'll go back there, boy. No, go on. Oh, you look like Blériot with a reverse bonnet. Kevin Stewart, only somebody of your age and stage would remember Louis Blériot. Louis Blériot, of course, fantastic, who was doing the old, Louis Blériot doing the old 99 flight. That was the thing. He flew in 99 degree. Wonderful. I was just thinking about that the other day. I had an uncle born in 1903, and, 1903, well, we called him uncle. He was a respected family friend. And he was born in 1903, and I thought that was the year the Wright brothers first flew. And Tom Sopwith was one of the earliest aviators as well. I think his license was 1912. Incredible stuff. You look like Blériot. Yes, thank you, Kevin Stewart. Louis Blériot, 1909, across the channel. We'll post you a bit later when I was out with the players during the Beast from the East between Carstairs and Carlisle. Up to 20-foot drifts. Do you know, Stephen, I'll tell you a funny story. I was going to do a shift at Border Television in Carlisle one afternoon. And I hadn't got the car. I think the car was being fixed or something like that. So I thought, no bother, I'll just get the train. Anyway, by the time I get in, the bus took so long. By the time I get into Glasgow Central, the train was about to go. So I ran up to the barrier and got stopped. One great big bear of a man said, whoa, sir, where do you think you're going? I said, Carlisle. No, Carlisle, sir, that's off now. I said, that off as in leaving. I said, well, the doors are okay, you know, just no, that's it. And just then, of course, the doors, and he's keeping me back. He said, sorry about that, no, you'll have to go and get the next one. Well, the next one was, went round the houses. This was a direct one. The next one stopped and you changed at Carstairs Junction. So here am I on a blistering hot summer's afternoon, right, having to make Carlisle in time, and I'm standing, marking time at Carstairs Junction. Oh, we made it though, we did make it. No mobiles in those days, none of that nonsense. Mae West used to be Snow White, and then she drifted. Oh, Kevin Stewart, you haven't lost your touch. My dogs got soaked today. The weather for the ducks. Kareem, what's it like? Do you know that at McClure Towers there was so much rain, it wasn't sinking into the ground? Place was awash. Incredible. We sort of the aqua. Mae West, will come up and see me sometime? That's one of my better impersonations. Then there's my Jimmy Cagney. Wonderful, wonderful. We had a guy, I can remember, used to do impressions and they were almost unrecognisable. But he insisted on doing them and he insisted on asking him to do them. And we were all going, is that, who was that? Was that Bob Hope you were doing there? No, that was Jimmy Cagney. Oh, I thought your first one was Jimmy Cagney. No, that was, and it was all that stuff. Just you know the kind. Did they not keep you in Carstairs Hospital there? No, Kevin, naughty. So there you go. No, they didn't. That, I think, must originally have been Carstairs House. Because I have an old etching of Carstairs House. And I'll bet you that became the hobby. So there you are. I bet you it did. A lovely, lovely wee village cast is on a summer's afternoon. It was one of those just stop the world, I've just got off, you know, and I was standing there and I thought, this is marvellous. The ground is like a swimming pool. I've just changed my clothes so many times today I need to take them out for a wee toilet break. This is for the dogs, of course. Absolutely, yes, indeed. Quite right, Kareem, yes. Stephen says, I was the signalman at Motherwell and split the trains at Carstairs, front portion for Glasgow, near for Edinburgh. Only the sleeper train still splits at Carstairs weeknights. I've been on the sleeper and I felt the wee dumped as they were obviously changing. Do they uncouple and pick the other one up or something like that? I certainly felt a wee jerk during the night. Rich Kent, Dinky Doo, lovely to have you with us. Enjoy our wee Archie Barges. There's been a lot of Archie Bargy, a lot of stuff. And a guy having a go at me last night saying, Scotty, you need to give up all this political stuff. You're becoming a puppet for that. And I thought, no, I'm not having this. I am apolitical, and, you know, I don't go in, but I do go in for the economics. What's best economically? There you are. But I don't think it's any secret that I'm no great fan of Brexit. And I'm, you know, terribly impressed with the way Scotland's being treated. So there we are. But that's just my opinion based on fact. Do you think there'll be a direct train link from Glasgow to Glasgow Airport? That would be a good thing. The wonderful Gordon Roddick. The story about Border TV reminds me of the many times I went down to Carlisle to record voiceovers and do some announcing shifts at Border, a great new station. You know, Gordon, it was a wonderful station. And when I was there, the original announcing team were there. And I just thought that was fantastic. And I remember a lovely afternoon, I'd opened up STV in the morning as an announcer, and then driven to Carlisle, and the guys at the transmitter thought that they were getting the wrong output at one point. And they said to your oppo down there, who's that guy? Because we lined him up with Scottish This Morning. He said, don't worry, no, he does all the stations. That was a rubbish impressionist. No, Kevin. Scotty, on a news station, will only enhance the nation. So that's certainly when we will tell 10. Yes, and I love the idea that technology will make it, that we can all get it. You know, I mean, that's the wonderful thing. We like that. So there we go. It'll be quite exciting. Yes, a wonderful wee station, Gordon. Fantastic. I loved the ITV network. Thought it was great. And I can remember auditioning for Thames Television in London. And I also auditioned for TVS in Maidstone in Kent. And I remember the chap in London coming in, he said, yes, you're very good, but it's coming across a little bit Scottish. And I said, oh, I wonder why that is. And the two of us just laughed. You know, but of course, a lot of Scots in London. There we are. Kevin Stewart says, we need another John Myers. Yes, we do indeed. What a great character John was, and taken from us far too soon. Far too soon. Wonderful character. Privileged knowing him. So I post about STV continuity announcers. Didn't know Dave Marshall was one. Yeah, I remember Dave well. Yes, he was a great, lovely, warm character. Was one of the most continuity announcers, cut the teeth to radio broadcasting after TV. No, you see, it tended to very often be the other way. And in some ways, I wish I had done it the other way. I wish I'd gone to radio first and then gone into television. But I just went straight into television. So there we are. So it was quite a step. I've noticed the media have been attacking the SNP, you would think an election's coming, says Karim. Yes, you would, wouldn't you, Karim? They're all sort of rounding up and attacking. And I found it very strange, because I noticed on television the other day, no names, no petrol, but they had the leader of an opposition party, and they were giving this person prominence. And I thought, why are you giving this person prominence? Because, you know, they're just a tiny, tiny sort of minority. And they were getting prominence, you know, it's very interesting. We need you back in the radio. We can never have too much McLean. We need more McLean in the airwaves. Well, Tony Mac, another 3 or 4 weeks, and we'll see what life brings us. Fantastic, that is. Now, have we done all the sharing we possibly can? Does everybody know that we're on here? What's going on here? I had a big friend the other day, and he said to me, sometimes people do say this to you when you're in the media. They go, trust you to get some publicity. Oh, trust me. And I said, well, sometimes you've got to run to catch the bus. But as if at my stage in the game, it's a problem. Do you know what I mean? Very, very strange. Where am I sharing to a group? Yes, I certainly am. I'll share to a group. And we'll just let them know that we are on. There's a nice one there. That's a goodie. We'll get on to that. Fantastic. And just create a public post. Wonderful, isn't it? Will you let everyone know when you start your new station, Scott? Of course we will, Karim. You'll see it on here. You'll see it all over the place. You know, because it's a huge, huge thing that's happening. And it will change the face of radio, you know. Tremendous. Because, as I say, it's on app. It's online. And we don't really have any proper talk radio these days. You know, you've got people talking at their audience, but not talking with their audience. And I think that's what it's about. Wonderful Jane McDonald, Dinky Doo, lovely to have you with us. Dave Marshall used to do the evening announcing shift on STV until midnight, then do the breakfast show on Clyde 2 starting at 6 a.m. Gordon Roddick, is that not fantastic? Fantastic. That was the way a lot of broadcasters worked, and when they were successful, like Dave most certainly was, the work just flowed in, you know, so that is tremendous, you know. Yes, I remember that, and you had quite a lot of, and you, of course, nobody will remember better than your good self, Gordon, how at Scottish Television, when we closed down and wished everybody a safe and peaceful good night, we also did a trio, you see, but local radio is on the air through the night, and we said on the East Coast you have Radio 4th, and on the West Coast, Radio Clyde. You know, but from all of us here at Scottish Television, I hope we've been good company. Good night all, and sleep well. Remember? And then you'd say, and of course, please remember to switch off your television sets. Good night. And then you'd put out a bit of tone, remember? Beep! And that told them to switch their sets off. The one Wayne Chadwick is watching. Tony Mac says, I'd love to do a bit of continuity announcing. It would be fun. Well, why don't you, Tony? Get in touch and say that you would like to do a shift or two. I mean, that's how we all started doing a few shifts, and then you get asked back, and that sort of idea. Wayne Chadwick, lovely to have you with us, and Dinky Doo, thank you for correcting me the other day. So there we are. I thought that was excellent stuff. Very good. I'm just doing a bit of sharing here, guys, because this is good. If you can all share as well, that would be helpful. Just say, watching Scotty McLeod's now. Tap, 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 de tap on your typing page. I'm going to share to another group. Yes, so just keep that going. Bobby used to play the national anthem at the end before the buzzer. Yes, Kevin, and Grampian played the national anthem as well. and Gordon will tell us whether STV did or not. Dave Marsh used to do the... Oh, yes, that's right. I remember when Breakfast and Radio Cloud, remember the rail check with John Sheridan and saw the wee broadcasting booth in our control room. Absolutely the wonderful John Sheridan, who I know very well, on the Rattlers. That was the one. Ray Moore used to call it the Rattlers. I look at the travel now, and in the air, and on the Rattlers. Good evening, Scotty. I just tuned in. When are you back in radio? Barry Crockendale. We'll be back probably within the month, I would think. So, kind of four or five weeks, that sort of stuff. We'll get it firmed up for you and then let you know. And it's big. This is big. And I mean big. Good evening, Sir Scotty. Neil O'Gormley, lovely to have you with us from Bournemouth. Am I right, Neil O'Gormley? Have I got that right? Now, come on. You've got to give me that one. Fantastic. There we are. We'll just share with this little group here. There we are. Lovely, lovely. Let everybody know what's what. That's what we like. I remember those days, Scotty, a good time ago, was it not? Oh, Billy Ness, 36 years since I started in television, and the wonderful Gordon Roddick would be a little bit ahead. You know, I shan't embarrass him by asking exactly when, but I think Gordon would have been... Now, let me see here. 30 years, 27 years before me, something like that. Would that be right, Gordon? Especially the newer technologies. But I'm a Paisley buddy. I know that, Neil. We know you're a Paisley man. And that doesn't do any harm down in Bournemouth. You'll probably find the place is awash with Scots. The Scots like to do that. They go to all these attractive places. Totally agreed. What have we got here? Do all these recordings and announcements still happen nowadays, or is it different? Totally different nowadays, the whole setup. Absolutely no doubt about that, yes. Huge difference nowadays on how... I mean, everything in ITV ran exactly to the second, 15 companies, all making sure that they coordinated together so that everything happened. There's the wonderful Steve Klinksky, or Dinky Do Steve, missing your chat. I'm going to give you a wee tune in the box there in a minute now that we've got the great Steve Klinksky, who I call Mr. Accordion. Yes, Klinksky's Accordions. Here we are. There we are, Steve. There's our wee friend. You haven't seen that one. You've seen the other one that's about 70 years old. Gordon says, after leaving STV and before I joined BBC Scotland, I used to present Flight Watch and Clyde 2 and Dave Breakfast Show. I remember that, Gordon, that wonderful voice of yours. Lovely, rich voice, saying, here are the problems today, or whatever, yes. And you'd tell us all any flights that were delayed or head up. It's all about voice tracking now to save cost. Yeah, that's great, saving costs, but eventually end up without much of a service. You think, what's the point? And that's why the youngsters are going to desert it. So, you know, you're not really, it's false economy to do all that. Remember the night call just before it closed down? Late call, Steve Menzies, yes? And I remember one of our wonderful announcers, Gordon will know exactly who I mean, and we had a horror film after late call. And the announcer had actually forgotten that late call was next, and he announced that now it's time for your appointment with fear. And up came some wee priest to give us late call. You know, he said, now it's time for your appointment with fear. And you had da 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 dee dee. And up came the CP and said, hello, how are we all tonight? What kind of day have you had? Thank you. What of that, Steve? I shall dedicate that one to you, to the wonderful Steve Dinkscale, Mr. Accordion. There we are. Great playing, Scotty. Thank you. Not at all. Will you not come back again? Oh, we're coming back again. There we are. Somebody, I could remember getting a presentation when I was leaving somewhere. And somebody made a wee speech. And they said, Scotty on King's Web. Fantastic, Steve Dinkscale. Top man. And I was leaving and I was getting, bravo, says the wonderful Stephen Menzies. And I was getting a presentation. And the girl said, we are going to miss him. And said, however, he's had more comebacks than Frank Sinatra. Radio 40, absolutely. Gaze the flower of Scotland, please, Scotty. It'll help our boys tomorrow against England. Well, I will, but I'd probably get hit with a copyright, so I'd better not. So there we are. It was Radio 4th. What was Steve? So there we are. Remember, don't watch Alone on a Friday night. It was supposed to be scary, but been brought up in Dumbarton. It was comedy gold. Absolutely, Peter Cuddley, all that stuff. And now, do you not think we've gone a bit bananas? It really annoys me when people start going, this might contain mild fright, you know, mild peril. And, you know, there's some mild peril in this. And there's some scenes of a slightly dodgy nature, you know, if you get my meaning. Don't tell us all that stuff, you know. You're just going to frighten us. There we are. Encore, encore. Steve's laughing. Susan Shaw, I think you do. Thank you. I like that tune too, Scotty. Thanks. Not at all, Billy. No problem at all. It's trad. It's traditional. James Mara, good evening, sir. Sorry for the absence. Still at the big tin box with a fire last Sunday. Looking up at the roof, I saw the smoke. I thought they'd elected a new pope. Here, here, pal. Encore, encore. There we are, wonderful Billy Ness. So, Scotty McClue back on the radio just for you, Dinky Doo, very, very soon. And I'll be expecting you all to call in. I think it might even be a free phone just to spoil you all. So there we are. Remember, we're not needing any second names, just first names. Well, somebody goes, line 3, Deaf Jimmy. Yes. Oh, that sort of stuff. It'll be wonderful. There we are. James Bauer, we'll give you a wee love. Fantastic. Everybody's getting a wee love. Billy Ness, get a wee love. Fantastic. There we go. Wonderful. I like to do that. It's very, very good. I'll be calling in. You'd better, Kareem. We'll give you a wee heart as well. Well deserved. I'll be there. Oh, you'll have a great time. It'll be fantastic. As I say, I've done some pretty big stations in my time. I mean, when they put the centuries together, you're looking at 9-10 million people. I mean, fantastic. You can ask Ronnie Brown for permission. I don't think he'd mind, as I believe he's a keen Scotland fan. Oh, fantastic man, Ronnie Brown. Wonderful. I think if I remember right, Ronnie started out as an art teacher. And the wonderful, very well-respected Roy Williamson. But if you listen to the tune, it's based, I mean, I've mentioned this to you before, but it's actually based on the chorus of the Hebrew Slaves from the opera Nabucco, and Speed Your Journey. So, you know, you might hear a male voice choir singing the chorus, dee 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 dee, speed your journey, and you think, oh, flower of Scotland. So there you are, so you've got a similar melody there. I hope you're feeling well, sir. Absolutely, James, and I hope you are. Looking forward to Scotty. Cheered, Scotty McClure. Oh, that's wonderful. We like that. I'll go through and give you all a heart later. Don't think I don't love you just because I haven't put a wee heart. We like our hearts. Going back to media studies. I loved your class. I learned a lot. That was a great day, Tony. We squeezed a lot into it. I remember somebody saying it might be an hour or two. I said, listen, the problem I have when I'm taking a class, whether it's university or college, or the seniors in a school or whatever. The problem I have is not how to fill the time. It's, you know, how can we get everything in that I want to tell you about? And I think that's the same. It's the same with the radio programs. You think we did 3 hours a night for, you know, 28 years or however long it was. 3 hours a night, 10 o'clock to 1 in the morning. And I never felt, whoa, that was a long shift, because we never managed to squeeze in all the stuff we wanted to talk about. You know, so it'll be a bit like that. There's Jack Malley's Dinky-Doo Scotty. Dinky-Doo Jack. My mum's a great fan, so got the Alexa set up for her. She's looking forward to the turn to hear this. And I'll tell you what to do, Stephen, if you've got a smart TV and you've got maybe the old Fire Stick or something, just say, Alexa, play Scotty McClure on YouTube, and you'll get something coming up, the latest YouTubes. Good night, sleep well, stay safe, Scotty. You too, Susan Shaw. My goodness, look at the time. I only popped up for a minute or two. My dad was a pal of Ronnie and Roy. The Corries are well missed. Billy Ness, I adored the Corries. They were absolutely outstanding because they made these old Scottish songs, traditional songs, that a lot of us would never have heard. They're not Scottish songs, old traditional songs. A lot of us would never have actually heard them if it hadn't been for the Corries. The Rose of Allendale, Allendale down in the borders there, just over in the other side. I mean, absolutely fantastic, Allendale, the Rose of Allendale, and Loch Lomond, these songs, Westering Home, you know, fantastic, and they really gave them life. You're correct about the tune for Flower of Scotland. Not many folks are aware of that. As a famous actor would say, not many people know that. So there you are. I'm glad I started in production before presenting. Great experience. All broadcasting and media experience is great experience. I wouldn't be surprised if I live to be an old man. If I go looking for maybe a wee job, I'll say, listen, if it's tidying up the stage or being the shush-shush man. I've been the shush-shush man at orchestral concerts, standing backstage and started. The shush-shush man. That's a great job as well. You know, I don't mind. And then I've gone on stage and introduced orchestral concerts. I've conducted one of the world's great orchestras in front of 20,000 people. You know, these wee things that just happen in life that you think, I don't believe this is happening to me. This is incredible. I just need to get on with it. But you've also got to deliver, as you know. And Gordon Roddy will know exactly what I'm talking about here. He has delivered all his life and done a fantastic job. Tremendous. Scotty, if you're leaving, take care. Stay safe. And Dinky-Doo, I will come in. I'm just going to push off for a minute. Was that impression Michael Caine or Max Bygraves? Aha, Kevin. I'm not going to tell you. You'll have to decide. See? Two can play at that game. So there we go. Fantastic. There's always, when I do a Welsh accent, people quite say, what part of India was this chap from? You know, and I think, oh, stop it. I know who that is too, says Billy Ness. Absolutely, Billy. So there we go. I'm not going to spoil everybody by telling them. People will have to have a look themselves. Fantastic. So there we go. It's been lovely, lovely, lovely to see you all. Absolutely tremendous. I think I'd better push off, do the decent thing and push off. And I'll pop this up on YouTube for you as well, so you'll be able to see that on YouTube at some point. Excellent stuff. It really has been a privilege being with you folks. Thanks very, very much for joining me. And lovely to hear from all of you again. And, you know, we'll maybe get some more pop-ups, but put a space in your diary for about a month's time that Scotty McClure's coming back on the radio just to say dinky-doo to every single one of you. We'll be taking phone calls, and it'll be growing across Europe. Missing you, Scotty, says the wonderful Steve Greenskill. Thanks for a great night, Stephen Menzies. Thanks for joining us. Bye, Dinky Doo. Fantastic stuff. Good night, Scotty. Graham Loudon. Good night, sir. Night, Scotty. Also, pleasure. Great education. Tony Mack. Dinky Doo. There we are. It's great to see you all. Fantastic. The audience will start to go up now that I'm going. Take care of yourselves, and I'll sing you the goodbye song. Are we ready? Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Take care, everybody, as you go. Goodbye, everybody. Auf Wiedersehen, au revoir, and a cheerio. Dinky Doo, thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay fabulous, and look after your dear selves. Ta-da, lads! Night, Scotty. Night, Peter Conley. That's time. There we are. Dinky Doo.